know, we have discussed many concepts like KCL, KVL, equivalent resistance, mesh analysis, loop analysis. Okay, so based on that, let us solve some problems. So the first question is like, find the voltage V. See, you have a current source which is delivering the current of 1 ampere series with 10 ohm resistor. Then you have 6 ohm, 6 ohms and V ohm. You know that any resistor which is in series with the current source, it can be neglected because it will be 1 ampere. Even if you have a resistor, it will be delivering the current of 1 ampere. See, you have the current 2A here. That means at this particular node, I can apply the KCL. So, KCL means 1 ampere plus 2 ampere. So, these are incoming currents. Now, let us consider this as the outgoing current. So that will be equal to Ix, okay? That will be equal to, Ix is equal to, so all this sum will be equal to 0. This is by KCL. So Ix will be equal to minus 3, right? Ix will be equal to, so 1 plus 2, it is incoming. Then this is outgoing. So you can write this as, Ix. Ix is equal to plus 3. Okay, so this will be equal to 3 amperes. Now we have to find the voltage V. Okay, so the current here is 3 ampere. This is 6 ohms. So now here I will apply KVL. So I will be considering the current in the anti-clockwise direction. We can also consider it in the clockwise direction. Okay, let us consider it in the clockwise direction. See, I am going this way, right? So if I am going, the current is flowing like this. That means you have the voltage drop like this. So the minus terminal first, that means it will be potential rise. So 6 into, what is the current? It is 3. Again here we have potential rise, that is plus 6 into 2, because the current that is flowing through that 6 ohm resistor is 2 amperes. Next we are getting positive terminal of the voltage source first. So it is considered as minus V. That is equal to 0. So V is equal to 6 3s are 18, 6 2s are 12. So that is equal to 30 volts. Okay. So first applying the KCL, then applying the KVL. So let us solve for R here. See, these two are in parallel. That means voltage across this also should be in parallel. So first let us convert this voltage source to current source. You know the conversion from voltage to current source. So if you have Vs, then if you have internal resistance Rs, this can be converted to current source. That is, Is will be equal to Vs divided by Rs. Then the internal resistance will be in parallel. Okay, because practical current source will be having the internal resistance in parallel to the ideal voltage source. So that is Vs by Rs. So 100 divided by 10, that is equal to 10 amperes, right? 10 amperes current and 10 ohm which is in parallel. So again we have another 10 ohm which is in parallel, and then we have R. This is 2 amperes. So this 2 can be simplified now. So that is, 2 equal resistors are connected in parallel. So this will be 10 divided by 2, that is equal to 5 ohms. Okay, so now you know the current through one branch, okay, and this is 10 ampere. So 10 ampere in 10 ampere, if 2 ampere is going through resistor R, so this will be obviously 8 ampere because it is a KCL. KCL at this particular node A, if I consider this as Ix, okay, 10 is equal to Ix plus 2, so Ix will be equal to 8 amperes. So this is 8 amperes. Now we can find the voltage across this resistor 5 ohm. V 5 ohm. What is the current? It is 8. What is the resistor? 5. This is Ohm's law, 40 volts. So the same voltage it will appear across this resistor. This is also 40 volts. Here we know 40 volts, that is equal to current is 2. We don't know the value of resistor R. So this gives you R is equal to 20 ohms. Okay, R is equal to 20 ohms. We can solve it by another method. So applying KCL. Okay. So KCL. So this is one junction. I'll name it as A. That is node voltage. Let it be V1. So this is the reference node because it has three branches connected to it that will be grounded. Out of the nodes, junction points present, one will be the reference node or the zero potential node. So at V1, I will be applying the KCL now. I'll take this as the current I1, this as I2, and this is 2 amperes, you know. So I1 is equal to I2 plus 2. Okay, so what is I1? You know, it is flowing from higher to lower potential. So if I come like this, you are getting the negative terminal first. So it is 100 minus V1 divided by 10. That is equal to I2 will be nothing but V1 minus 0 divided by 10 plus 2. So this can be written as 20 divided by 10. So 10 cancels out. Okay, then you have 100 minus 20, that is 80. If V1 comes to the right hand side, it becomes 2V1. That means V1 is equal to 40 volts. If V1 is equal to 40 volts, then I can consider, okay, this one, 40 volts, that is equal to 2 into R. That means R is equal to 20 ohms. This is another method of solving this particular circuit. Next, let us consider another problem where we have to find the value of R. In this figure, we have to find the value of R. See, we have a voltage source and here 8 ampere current is flowing. What is the value of R? See, these two resistors are in parallel. So, I can write this as 5 ohms. So, equivalent resistance will be 10 divided by 2. Here we have R and this is the voltage source, 100 volts. So, this is the current 8 ampere. Now, applying the KVL now, what happens? First is a positive terminal, 100, minus 8, this R voltage drops, okay, 8 into R minus 8 into 5, that is equal to 0. So, 100 minus 40, that is equal to 8R. So, this is nothing but 100 minus 40 is 60, is equal to 8R. So, you know, 4 ones are, okay, then you have 15, it is 2, then that is equal to 15 divided by 2, that is nothing but it is 7.5 ohms. So, R will be 7.5 ohms. Now, let us consider another problem. Here we have a current source of 2 amperes. This is 1 ohm. This is 12 ohms. R. This is the voltage source, 6 volts. Okay. The current which is flowing here is 1 ampere through that particular branch. See, if 2 ampere is flowing in this direction and 1 ampere is going in this branch, obviously this should be equal to 1 ampere. Right? That will be 1 ampere. Now I will apply the KCL, 12 into 1, since it is in this direction, we are getting minus plus, so it is potential rise. Next we have 1 into R, that is R, then we have minus 6 is equal to 0. R is equal to 12 minus 6, that is equal to 6 ohms. Okay, that is equal to 6 ohms. Now we will consider another one, sixth problem. So here the current and voltage sources are considered as ideal. We have to find V out. This is 5 ampere, this is 2 ohm, this is 10 volts. Okay, we have to find the V out. So now this I can convert into current source, right? This is 5 ampere. While converting voltage source to current source, you know, this divided by this will be equal to Is. So 10 divided by 2 is 5 ampere. This is 2. So 5 and 5, it will be getting added and the direction will be equal because both the values are equal. 10 ampere. This is 2 ohms. Okay, 10 ampere, that is 2 ohms. Then what will be our voltage? See, the current which is flowing here, okay, the value will be equal to 10 into 2, that is 20 volts. So the same voltage should appear here, V out, that is equal to 20 volts. Okay, it is 20 volts.